Who has not heard this music before? We are all familiar with the music of Ludwig van Beethoven. We hear it on records, we hear it on the radio, we hear it in concert. We are fortunate that we have this music to listen to, but Beethoven, the creator of all this lovely music, heard some of it only in his head, in his inner ear, never in concert. Beethoven was deaf. This wasn't always so. As a young man, Beethoven never dreamt that one day he would lose his hearing. As a boy, he had other problems. He had a cruel father who wanted to make Beethoven a second Mozart. So poor Beethoven was forced to practice all day long, sometimes even all night. Most children would end up hating music after such treatment, but not Beethoven. His love for music was greater than any hardship that could befall him. When he was older, he left home and went to Vienna to study with Haydn. This relationship didn't last long, however, because Beethoven's ideas in music were too new and different for old Papa Haydn. Beethoven's head was always full of musical ideas, and he put all of them down on paper. In order not to lose any of them, he would carry a musical sketchbook with him at all times. Whenever a musical idea came to his mind, he would put it down in his sketchbook. While walking in the Vienna woods, he would get an idea. And write it down. Sitting on a tree limb, he had a musical idea. And wrote it down. Lying on the grass, he would put down any musical idea that would come to his mind. Then he would take all these ideas and work on them and develop them into his great music. Sometimes Beethoven put his feelings to music. When he was in love, he wrote the beautiful Moonlight Sonata. As he was growing older, his deafness increased. He was very unhappy about it, but he didn't let it interfere with his composing. When he wrote his most famous symphony, the Ninth Symphony, he was completely deaf. When the symphony was performed and the audience applauded enthusiastically, a friend turned Beethoven to face the audience so he could see the applause. He couldn't hear it. He died a famous man, and 20,000 people came to his funeral. Just the opposite of Mozart, to whose funeral nobody came.